Studio, is it a sanctuary? Yes, it is. I think that it's really important to touch on the fact that everybody here has their own little place where they actually connect into the music and listen to the gods of hip-hop. Never comes tomorrow. Tomorrow never. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow never comes tomorrow. My name's Scythe. I make beats, engineer, and I'm an MC. I guess it all started from my family upbringing, kind of forced to join band at a young age, and it being in the family, had to figure my way through music, and I ended up finding hip hop when I was about 13 years old.
I go by the name Azrael. First time I heard rap music, it just completely captivated me. Started off with Criss Cross, wearing my clothes backwards to school and all that, and just progressed from there, and I just never let it go.
My name is Nicky Scarfo, the Chow Fodder.
Hey.
Hey. I'm the oldest cat in the group here, and I've been around for a while. My hip hop upbringing was at an early age, so I listened to, you know, old tracks, you know, like N.W.A. It was my first get up there.
This is Copacetic, and I got into Illegitimate because we shared a similar vision for quality music and movement, you know, with the right intention.
Anonymous represented Illegitimate to the fucking death of me. I've been involved in music since I was 2 and a half. Just, you know, playing violin and you know, I got into piano when I was young, 5, and I've always been around music. My family, on my father's side, with traditional Italian music, has always, you know, been huge. Hip-hop-wise, I started writing rhymes at a young age, but I never really exposed myself until later on. I didn't really think there was an ear for it, so I did it all in my own time. And, yeah, I guess that's how I got into it.
Fees, killing MCs. Whoa. The mass morphs like a transformer. The reaper's at the door asking for ya. California to Newfoundland and Labrador. Throw me in the category of an Allosaurus. If you ask for gore, won't bring out.
Best place to listen to music? Depends on the purpose, right? You know, we'll all give you a different answer for that if it comes to where we want to produce. You know what I mean? But where's the best place to listen to music generally? I prefer listening just for listening on the studio monitors. You know, if I just have to play some tracks, oftentimes Scythe and I are in there, you know, doing our thing. We play through tracks. I like hearing them on the studio monitors. Also, when we're working, we can sort of compare how mixing and everything goes to the regular. But when I write, I want to be plugged in my head, with my headphones on, locked in a space where I can't be heard, or preferably when the room is dead, and on my laptop.
What do I like to listen to music? Let me tell you. In a basement, deep, dark basement, preferably my mother's basement. Hey, I'm Italian, you know? What are you talking about here? Come on. But, you know, I sit there, kind of like Anonymous here. Got my monitors on, listening, full blast, shutting everything out, eating a plate of pasta. You know what I'm talking about?
What I usually do is take my earbuds and just walk around the city for an hour, you know, in my travels. And that's usually what gives me things to write about. I just take my earplugs and walk around and compile thoughts, and, you know, next time I'm in the studio, then I have a pile of things to take from. I'm very visually engaged with everything that's going on around me and trying to be as observant as I can, and that just helps me to write, because it's just giving me all sorts of ideas, directions I could take things, and they could come out of nowhere too. I mean, I could be on the bus and think of 4 or 5 bars that you know, have nothing to do with being on the bus.
Sometimes the best place to listen to beats isn't in the studio at all. Because if you're in the studio, you're just in the same box, right? A lot of times I'll make beats, obviously, in the studio, because I have to be in the studio doing that. And if I am doing that, then if I'm writing to that beat, I usually like to write right away. But a lot of my writing, like Az said, might just happen, like you're at work or something, just doing mindless work, and something has to come to you, right? You know, you can put together half of 16 right there, right?
All of our talents together, one thing. It's like a dish, you know, like you get like like a saucepan. That's the beat. You got, since I'm Italian, I'm gonna only use extra virgin olive oil. And then you know, you got a little bit of spicy, you got a little bit of broccoli over there, you got a little bit of beef over here, you got a little bit of noodles over there. It's like it's a collection of all of our talents amalgamated together in one like beautiful soul.
If it makes somebody laugh, if it makes somebody angry, then I guess we've kind of done our job because we brought some emotion to something.
Keeping it raw comes with not trying to keep it raw. Not everybody has that ability. A lot of people would maybe go about their craft a little contrived and it wouldn't come out raw or what have you. But I don't know, the way that we attack it, it's kind of... We attack it very organically.
We're just trying to communicate our personal experiences, our character, our charisma. The Illegitimate album encompasses the last few years of the hard work that we put in, and it really has a broad timeline. So you're going to hear some of our old classics and a lot of new stuff. And it's really like a sampler for all of the artists under Illegitimate.
This is Anonymous representing Illegitimate. We communicate by poetry in motion, musically, in the form of a sword that'll cut your fucking head off.